Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com, and in this series I will teach you how to use MBProgressHUD. So without further ado, let's get started. Okay, now what is MBProgressHUD? Now, if you are using iOS apps at all, then you might have progresses inside your app, and then you need to show a little progress hub for the user in order not to terminate the background altogether. So for that, to using progress huds, the best way is to use someone else's work from GitHub, and that is MBProgressHUD, a very fine-tuned, top quality GitHub repo. So in this video, in this first episode, I will just show you what MBProgressHUD can do, and then we will just simply create a new project, and I will just import MBProgressHUD through Cocoapods. And we are going to create this project because I will go into detail of every little aspect of MBProgressHUD, all the properties, all the methods, and you will get to learn in this series. So let's go ahead and take a look at MBProgressHUD. So go open up your favorite browser and type in HUD, and maybe type in GitHub, and the first one should appear from JDG, and let me just click on there, and here we are inside MBProgressHUD. As you can see, there are a lot of stars, a lot of watches, top quality GitHub repo for iOS apps. Now let's just scroll down and let's take a look at a few images here, and if you just go down there, you will see that you can install it via Cocoapods cartridge, source files. We will use Cocoapods, but what I want to show you is the usage. As you can see, this is an Objective-C library, and the usage and the example that you will see in just a minute is written in Objective-C. Now, we will dive into MBProgressHUD in Swift. You will be able to quickly learn how to use MBProgressHUD inside your Swift iOS apps. Okay, now what I want you to do now is, well, let's first of all clone our this MBProgressHUD repo in our desktop. So I will just simply click on open in Xcode. Okay, that will verify MBProgressHUD. And now, the default folder is documents, but I will just go ahead and put it in my desktop under GitHub clones. Okay, let's clone it. And we are inside the MBProgressHUD readme file. This is why this is just a little bit weirder than original, what we are used to inside our Xcode files. So here we have our MBProgressHUD. We will not take a look at this at the moment. Instead, as you can see, of course, this MBProgressHUD is for TV apps as well, Apple TV apps as well. So let's take a look at the demo. Okay, here we have our app delegate, and as you can see, these are H and M files, because they are all written in Objective-C. This example demo is written in Objective-C, and here is our view controller and the M file according. And here we have our examples. We will take a look at how to write these examples in details in a later videos. Okay, and of course we have our resources info plist file, our UI, and in the image assets we have a checkmark that we will use as a custom view. Well, we will talk about this in later videos when we get to those types of progress HUDs. Okay, for now let us just choose our HUD demo, and don't be fooled by the indicator here. This is the actual app icon. I just got a little confused at first, but go ahead and This is not doing anything in the background, it's just the app icon of the HUD demo. So I just choose iPhone 10 and let us just build and see how the examples are laid out and maybe show you some of them in this video. Okay, here we go. It is loading up, and as you can see, we have a table view, well, a navigation bar up here, and a table view with, well, I accidentally tapped on that, with sections. Okay, let's go over them one by one so you may get accustomed to the huge power MBProgressHUD can give you. So here we have an intermediate boat. Of course, I will not go into detail in this video. I'm just going to show you what this does. Okay, here we have a simple progress spinner going. And now we have with a label. It says loading, good stuff, a lot of examples out there. And here we have a second detail label. Let me just show you again. Loading and parsing data. And of course, you can see that the details label is longer than one line, and that is taken care of MBProgressHUD. It wraps longer text into lines. Okay, now here we have a determinate mode, a cool animation. It is, well, loading something, annular determinate mode. Really cool animations, we will dive into them later on. And here we have, of course, our bar loading. And here's an interesting one that I really liked. This is the text only. It displays a message text down below. Of course, you can set where the text message should be displayed. Okay, here we have a custom view. Okay, the custom view is the check mark, and you can add different custom views, of course. And here we have a wait action button. Of course, we can cancel it. And of course, we may wait for the loading to proceed. Okay, next up, we have a mode switching. Now, this is interesting because if you have more than one, let's say actions or tasks, during that time that you want to present the progress HUD, and maybe add a success progress HUD at the end, then you can use mode switching. We will dive into how to create this later on. So we are preparing now, we are loading, and once the loading is finished, then we are cleaning up, and it says right here, completed. This is very, very useful and quite good for the user experience. If we have, of course, long taking tasks. Now here we have an on window. This is presented on the window. We will dive in later on. NS URL session, we're preparing and completed. Determinate NS progress. Of course, we can cancel this out if we want. Now we can also dim the background. And this is just the light version. I don't know if you can see this. Let me show you again. It kind of dimmed the background. We have a dark mode too. And well, not we, MBProgressHUD has. And of course, we can color the HUD with any color that we want. And that is all. Of course, there are many other use cases that we will dive on in the next videos. But as you can see, there's a lot of options and a lot of potential in using MBProgressHUD. Now, next up in the second part of the video, we are going to create a new project and we are going to install MBProgressHUD to our project via Cocoapods. Now, let's just close this and let me just create file, new, and a new project. Okay, it will be a single view application. Let's click on next. And I will type this, and the language will be Swift, and let's click on next. Okay, I will just drop it onto the desktop here, and I will create a Git repository because you will be able to take a look at the code on my GitHub account. Okay, let's create it. And here we go. Let's add our source control. Let's create a remote here. Create MBProgressHUD Swift remote on GitHub. I will just use my Rebeloper account. It will be a public. Now let's create this. This is basic GitHub stuff that you need to set up if you want to use GitHub in your project. And I highly recommend it. Go ahead and take a look at my GitHub educational videos. It's a whole playlist with pushes and pulls and how to use GitHub. So go ahead and check that out if you don't know what I'm doing right now. Okay, now, next up is that we want to close this project because we want to add a Cocoapod. So we need to use the Cocoapod way. So for now, let's just open our project. Let's navigate to our project. Here it is, MBProgressHUD Swift. And now let's open up terminal. So terminal here, and let's type in cd and the space and drag and drop MBProgressHUD Swift. And let's just hit return there. And now let's type in pod in it so we may create our pod file. Okay, here is our pod file. It has been created. Pod file creation, of course, I do have another playlist here. Go ahead and check that out if you want to find out what I'm actually doing here. Okay, here we have our pod file open inside our Xcode. I will just comment this out, and well, iOS 9 is okay. MBProgressHUD supports, I believe, even lower than iOS 7 version, so this is really good stuff. And now let's just go back to Chrome and take a look what we need to add inside. Well, here we have MBProgressHUD and a version number, and we will just simply copy this out and paste it inside our pod file and maybe save it. Either way, when you close it, it should be saved, but better be on the good side. So next up, we type in pod install, and this will install our project, well, the pod into our project. Okay, and that is it. From now on, let's open up Finder. From now on, we will use the XC workspace, and let's open this up. And as you can see here, we have our pods, our pod file, and our MBProgressHUD installed inside our code. And of course, here we have our MBProgressHUD Swift, basic Swift app delegate and view controller. Okay, and of course we have our main storyboard, which we will get rid of in the next video, where we will set up the UI for all of these examples. So hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope you will use MBProgressHUD in Swift. If you will use it in Swift, go ahead and take a look at my next videos where we will dive deeper into MBProgressHUD. And in the next one, I will just simply create the user interface for this example Swift project that will use MBProgressHUD. So go ahead and give it a thumbs up for this video if you liked it, and of course subscribe to the channel if you haven't already done so, or maybe share it with your friends. Go ahead and take a look at rebeloper.com for more of my stuff, and as usual, I will see you in the next one.